Hey guys, it's Karen again. My review for Robin Hood. And what Robin Hood is essentially about is basically we center on our main character, of course, Robin Hood, and he is someone who is basically forced to become an outlaw after this whole battle that takes place, and he ends up losing the love of his life. She ends up marrying someone else. Basically, he decides to team up with Jamie Foxx's character in a hope to revolt against the corporate people that have taken everything from him, and also hopefully win Marion back. And that's really all I'm going to say. So, Robin Hood overall, I really did not care about this movie. I mean, this is one of those films where it's coming out, and I've seen so many trailers for it, and I just don't care that it's coming out. And I don't think many people do, honestly. It's coming out at such a horrible time against, like, Ralph Breaks the Internet and Creed 2, and I really was not expecting much of anything from this film, and hearing that it was coming out on, like, a Monday night was actually very enticing, because I'm like, oh, I can get this out of the way, and that's exactly what I ended up doing. I ended up seeing Robin Hood, and to be honest, this film is everything that I expected it to be. Robin Hood is one of the blandest and laziest remakes I have seen in a very long time, but we're just getting to right now, starting off with the cast. Now, let me just tell you guys right now, for the most part, this cast is awful. I mean, there really isn't anyone here that I can say, oh, they're amazing, they're a standout. Really, almost everyone sucks. Except for Taron Egerton, and going into the film, he was my one sort of, he was the one glimmer of hope. Like, this is a film that I really was dreading, but he was kind of the one thing that I think could have elevated this film, and while it didn't quite get there, I do think Egerton still does a good job in this role. You could tell he was definitely into it, he was definitely having a lot of fun, and even at points where this role isn't working, Egerton still does a very good job here. He remains to be a very charismatic and fun actor. I like what he's doing here. I really do want to see him scale back from films like this, though, because it very much shows how much they are wasting his talents and how much they are not worth his time. Things like Rocket Man, that's what he needs to be doing, not stuff like this. But there are scenes in this film where he really does shine. Anytime Robin Hood has to give, like, a motivational speech, he really does pull it off. But he also does a good job at some of the more fun scenes in the film. I just really liked Egerton's incarnation of this character. He doesn't particularly do anything new with the character, but like I said, he was into it, I felt his enthusiasm, and that's one of the only positives I really can give this film. The rest of the cast, on the other hand, no. I mean, really no one really worked for me. Now, I will say, admittedly, Jamie Foxx is not as bad here as I thought he would be. I don't really love his accent, but I do think him and Egerton did work well together. His character is a different story, but Jamie Foxx, for the most part, I thought he did the best job he could with what he had. I do think he's very much miscasted in this role, but I think, you know, for what he had, he did the best job that he possibly could. Jamie Dornan, I actually didn't think was as bad as I thought he was going to be. This is definitely a bit of a step up from 50 Shades. Until, like, the end of the movie, he did have some scenes at the end that were a little bit shaky, but definitely, nothing too bad. The two performances, though, that really stuck out to me as really terrible. One is Eve Hewson. Eve Hewson in this movie, she plays Marion, and this has to be one of the blandest love interests I have seen in so long. I mean, she has no role in the movie. She barely even has a character in this film. She's simply just the chick that Robin Hood likes, and that always seems to be doing things in his favor, and she is to refer to him as Rob. And look, this is the actress from The Nick. This is the actress that played Lucy Elkins on The Nick and was so great in that role. And to see her here just not give a damn. I mean, you can tell she does not really care about this role. There's no chemistry between her and Egerton, by the way. But she is so wooden here. I really could not stand her. However, she's nothing compared to Ben Mendelsohn, who, holy shit, I mean, I have heard so many people say that Ben Mendelsohn needs to stop playing villains, and this role absolutely proves it. I mean, this has to be, I think, the worst role he has pretty much ever played. I mean, there's nothing to this villain. The only thing there is to this villain is for him to whine and complain about Robin Hood, and it gets really annoying after a while. This is the definition of just a one-note corporate villain who really doesn't seem to have any other agenda than just overthrowing Robin Hood, and Making sure things go in his favor and making sure that he's the ruler of everything. He's just that same sort of elitist villain that we've come to know. And look, it worked in something like Ready Player One because they were purposely trying to make a jab at someone like, say, Steve Jobs, and they did a good job with that. Here, it just comes across as lazy, and it just comes across as like they didn't really know what to do with him as a villain. You never once feel his presence. You never once feel his menace in the film, and I really hated him a lot here. Anytime he came in the film, this film is really bad for the most part, but anytime he came on, things were infinite, just immediately worse, and I really hated him overall. Most of this cast here is really bad. Mostly everyone just doesn't really care at all, and I really could not stand most of the cast here. But now I really want to get to the directing and the writing, which holy shit, do we have a lot to talk about. I mean, right off the bat of the directing, though, I really don't know what happened here. Otto Bathurst, this is just such lazy directing. There's nothing to this directing. There's nothing really distinct that he does, and it seems like he doesn't really know what he wants this movie to be, because he does set it in the typical time that Robin Hood is usually set, but he does it in such a way where it feels like it's trying to be like an edgy, modern sort of remake of Robin Hood, and it just does not work at all. There's never a point in this movie where you felt tension. The comedy falls extremely flat. Like, holy shit, does it fall flat? We'll get more to that with the writing, but it really does not work at all. You never really feel the action in this movie. I mean, everything about this directing is just so half-assed. It really feels like they could have gotten anyone to direct this movie, and the movie probably would have turned out exactly the same. I mean, maybe if you got a better director, then maybe it could have been elevated, but someone like this, I mean, this is a no-name director, and they got him for a very good reason because they need a director, and that's very much what this film feels like, and especially when it comes to the writing, which is easily the worst thing about this film. I mean, this is probably one of the worst screenplays of the entire year for me. I mean, just the story in general is so paint by numbers. I mean, it's every single story you've seen a Robin Hood, but it's done in a very self-indulgent way. We really don't need this version of Robin Hood. There really is nothing particularly different about this story at all, and I think that's what makes it just so embarrassing at points. The story as well here is really not interesting. It's very by the numbers, and the character of Robin Hood isn't even really that likable. All we really know about him in this film is that he's an outlaw and he really loves Marian, and that's kind of it. His only motivation for doing things is for Marian. The whole purpose of why he wants to become the Hood, because that's what they have to call him in this movie, because, oh, we just gotta keep calling him the Hood throughout. It's because he's so cool and everything. His only motivation is because he wants to be with Marion. He wants to win her back. And admittedly, that doesn't sound like a bad motivation, but again, there's nothing else to his character. They don't do anything interesting with him. And same with the other characters here. There's just nothing to them, and it's just so lazy. It outright tries to avoid any sort of interesting character development it does in favor of just telling a really cliched story that I just did not give a shit about in this film. The story, while it is paint by numbers as well, also is extremely rushed. I mean, there really isn't anything that interesting going on in the story. It takes forever to get to the Robin Hood that we know, with like all his merry men and things like that. And at that point, you just stop caring. And I really couldn't stand what they did there. And also, like I said, going back to the humor in this movie, it is awful. It is some of the worst humor I've seen, I think, in any movie this year. There is one scene in particular involving the villains. Anytime the villains came on screen, which they are so over the top and cheesy to the point where, A, I couldn't take them seriously, B, I couldn't help but get irritated by them. There's one sequence of them in particular in this film that felt like self-parody. It felt like they were making fun of Robin Hood. It felt like this was like Robin Hood Men in Tights 2, but that's not what this is. For what I gathered, I mean, we're supposed to take this moment seriously, but the way it's done in a way where you think you're watching like an Aaron Friedberg and Jason Seltzer movie. Again, I'm not joking about this. Like, it legitimately feels like a parody movie, and it was just so weird the way they did go about it. There are several moments like that in this film, and I don't know what they were trying to convey there. Were they trying to give some levity to this film? Because if that was true, that certainly didn't work. Were they trying trying, if they were trying to take it seriously, then that's even more embarrassing. But the way it was done here just really did not work at all, and I just don't think it really made sense in the terms of the story here. This film also has, I think, one of the most obnoxious narrations I've heard in recent memory. Now, admittedly, it doesn't come up a lot. We only hear it in a couple spots here and there. But whenever it came up, the film got so much more annoying. Because like I said, this is trying to be the cool, hip Robin Hood, and it does not work at all. The movie literally opens with a line where they say, like, oh, this isn't your typical bedtime story. And, oh, you know, forget everything you know about the Robin Hood characters. Again, they're trying to be, like, edgy and different. But what they do at the end of this movie takes the cake. I mean, if you weren't hating the film, you know, before, you will absolutely hate it by the end of this movie. I mean, it's probably one of the worst narrations I have heard ever. I mean, I don't know why it's in this movie other than the movie wants to be so fucking self-indulgent and different and appeal to the teen masses, and it just does not work at all here. The cinematography in this film also is awful. There really isn't anything in this film that feels like it fits in tone with what the time period is. I mean, the film's supposed to take place in, like, you know, typical, like, I'd say, you know, typical, the time period that Robin Hood usually takes place, you know, and in, like, 17th century, 13th, 14th century, you know, England. It's supposed to take place then, and it doesn't feel like it. Like, sure, their costumes do, but the way the film is done, everything about it feels so modern. It feels like they so desperately wanted to make a modern version of Robin Hood, but they foregoed any sort of sense of originality and instead just went with a very traditional story. And because of that, the cinematography comes off very out of place. I mean, there are a lot of shots in this film that are in slow-mo. There's a lot of shots in this film that utilize, you know, just a lot of weird camera placement and things like that. The film at points also looks like a CW show. It's just really that cheap, and I really was not a fan of the cinematography, but especially when it comes to the action sequences, which, admittedly, the first one isn't that bad. I really did not hate the first action scene, but as they go on, they really do get worse and worse. Like I said, the film uses a lot of slow-mo, and at points it does feel like a movie from, like, the late 90s. Like, it really does feel like it's that dated, and I think it's one of those films that, like, is going to be dated, like, very quickly, because the action is just kind of unwatchable here. The score's fine, I guess. There's really not much to it. And the editing, this film is only under 2 hours, but it felt so long. It drags and drags through so many things, and it spends way too much time in getting to the story of Robin Hood, you know, becoming, becoming part of, you know, with his merry men. Like, a lot of this film is him as, like, a vigilante of sorts, and they're trying to turn him into, like, Arrow or something, and it just does not work at all. I don't really get what they're trying to do with this film. The directions that they take, just the pacing in general, is really not there. The film is either too rushed or it's too slow, and it really never seemed to blend as well as it could. Ultimately, Robin Hood is just kind of a disaster. I mean, that's really the best way to sum it up. This film is a complete disaster. It's one of those films where it's trying to set up this, like, modern franchise and being the cool action Robin Hood, and that's not at all what it comes off. It just comes off very self-indulgent and cringy, and it just never really worked for me. It has a really good performance from Taron Egerton and some good action sequences here and there, but really, other than that, there's really not much to like about this film at all. I really hated Robin Hood a lot, and I'm definitely going to give Robin Hood a D. Just skip it. You're not going to see it anyway. I don't think this is on anyone's list, but I got out of the way. It's seen. We can move on to other movies. But that's it for this video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you haven't seen this movie, don't. It's definitely not worth your time. It's not making, like, any money at the box office anyway. But that's it for this video. Hope you enjoyed it. I'll see you guys in my next video, and we'll see you guys for that. Okay, bye.